13th of the 10th, 2011. And this is an update on the Katla volcano in Iceland and the latest findings. I remember the volcano that went off last year in Iceland, causing all the major air traffic problems across Europe? The Eyjafjallajökull, which released an ash plume high into the atmosphere. Well, they're now giving a comparison of what would happen if Katla were to blow, if there were to be a big eruption, what sort of problems would this create as regards air traffic? They're saying that the ash cloud that Katla could produce would dwarf the 2010 eruption, which cost the airlines $2 billion, and just sort of reinforce just how vulnerable modern society actually is by the whims of nature. Now, the eruption at Eyjafjallajökull was described as not small, but in comparison, Katla, which her name has been taken from an evil troll, the name Katla, she has a much larger magma chamber than the smaller volcano adjacent to her, which went off last year. Now, her last major eruption was in 1918, and it went on for more than a month, and it turned day into night. It starved all the crops of sunlight, and it killed off livestock. It also melted ice sheet covering Katla, flooding surrounding farmlands with a torrent of water that some say measured twice as wide as the Amazon. Now, the earthquake swarm is still being detected around Katla, though not so big. But it does mean a major eruption could be imminent, the seismologists are saying. The actual earthquakes have been growing in strength as well. Now, after a long period of magnitude 3 tremors, magnitude 4 was detected. I saw this on the map. I wondered why it hadn't been reported, but there was a 4, I think it was last week. Yes, it says last week. So it's definitely showing signs of restlessness and could be some major activity there soon, a professor of geophysics at the University of Iceland is saying. And teams of seismologists and geologists at the university are tracking the spike in seismic activity and working with officials to prepare communities near Katla, particularly a town called Vik, which is flanked by black sand beaches. Regular meetings have been held with the civil defence authorities and scientists, and the disaster officials have also drafted an evacuation plan and have also put in place temporary housing should it be needed. But many fear that they may have less than an hour to evacuate once the volcano erupts. Iceland sits on a large volcanic hotspot in the Atlantic's mid-oceanic ridge, and eruptions common throughout Iceland's history are often triggered by seismic activity when the Earth's plates move and magma from deep underground pushes its way to the surface. In 1783, there was a major eruption of Laki, one of Iceland's deadliest, and it freed poisonous gases that turned into smog and floated across the jet stream, killing thousands of people with toxic fumes in the British Isles alone. Laki is a volcanic fissure situated in the south of Iceland, not far from the canyon of Eldgjá. When Laki erupted, the mountain itself did not erupt, but fissures opened up on each side of it, and it is part of a volcanic system centering on the Grímsvötn volcano, and that's where we see a lot of activity on that one too. It lies between the glaciers of Mýrdalsjökull and Vatnajökull, both active, in an area of fissures which run in a south-west to north-east direction. Now, this is an area, and this is a place to be keeping your eye on with these volcanoes, and I certainly intend to do that. Thanks, YouTube.